Hi, and welcome to our Open Stop Motion film project. We have been down a couple of days of different reasons. First of all, the net provider has to update, and I took the same, or I took the chance to update something at the same time, and then I made a little intro to new viewers on the channel, so you can see here. I will first set some audio on it, if I can find it. Yes. I have a tree in the way of what I'm doing. Here it is. So you can see now. Just a little intro, 19 seconds, so people have an idea of what this is about. You can see. Okay, it go loops, that was not the plan, but you understand how. And it took a couple of days to make that one, so. But today we have to get on with what we was making last time. We have to make some leaves. And we used spray glue to put the leaves on the twigs. So, but we very fast got out of glue. So. And these containers only have 200 milliliters in them. So today I found another one. I want to try before I buy a lot of them. And they are 500 milliliters in them. So, and it's cheaper to buy a big one. So. That was pretty, but I'm also getting out of what do we call it, silk paper to make the leaves of, so I had to buy something of that too. And those I went and I have bought some more of that, so now we should have to hold the trees, as you can see. Here we have a lot of trees without leaves, even when we put leaves on some of them last time. So, but there's still a lot to put something on. So, but first we will go and clip some new ones like these. And then we will glue them and then mount them to the tree, like you can see on this one. So that's what we're gonna do tonight. And I will take the mic with me and my coffee and what else. Over to the other place so we can get on with it. Then I can keep an eye on what you can see. You can see I have the screen over there behind, so I can see. Sure that you can see what's going on. I have a habit of sometimes forgetting that. And the way I make these leaves is that I light and whatever. And the noise you can hear in the background is the rain on the roof. And the studio is on the top floor, so the idea behind this is that when I clip one with the scissors, then I have multiple, many leaves each time. Guess you have figured that out already. It has to be a little precise, because otherwise when I put them, then they string together. I have an example here. You can see here. And they stick together like this. And that's not good. Sometimes when you're cutting a lot, then errors occur. Sharp, so we prevent it from sticking together. Thank you. signature. It's very thin paper. It's like cigarette paper. Thank you. what if I used a stick? We rolled it, maybe, and then flattened it. I don't know if it will work, but we will try. Cannot get it off this one, so that was no a good idea. Nothing to gain there. Thank you. I can get it off. It would be much easier. Because now I have something to draw in. Take another stick. wasn't good. I must be able to do something. Experiment a little here. Something for drawing the other end to. Sanded in the end, so it's easier to work with. Thank you. So from now on, this one is a leaf tool. You will. Christen it. And if we were Microsoft or Apple, we would patent it, but we are not. I will just be happy that it make my life easier. So, and then we did this. Nothing better when it's when a plan comes together. But maybe we shouldn't jinx it just now. Maybe I could stick a little bend. So it's a little easier to get off. Thank you. get a little better to this rolling stuff here. The first step. Than the other way. One was before we know it, we maybe be good at this. One never knows. It's kind of the same as rolling cigarettes, but without the lick. Oof. And that's also tough to do when you haven't done it before. Bad enough, you will learn it.
out here just a moment. Place the paper somewhere else instead of reaching over the camera all the time. So do it like this. I forgot. We are doing it like this. Up a bit. fancy, then we could split the stick down the middle, so we could just enough so you could get a sheet of paper in between, and then it would be really easy to get hold of the paper, I think. But now we do it this way. If you made a split right through all the way up in from here to where the paper ends here, then you could put the paper in and then just twist the stick around. I think I will do that, not now, but another day, because we have to make autumn leaves also. So it will come to good use. And then we will be really happy producing, maybe. Guy making all this, then you need to think of that sort of thing. When you do it on a shoestring budget, you could get a laser cutter and then cut and leaves out. You could also the old way of doing things, you could stamp it on out on a Heidelberger machine. But I have to think of the cost all the time, so see, we get lots of leaves. We cut all these out with the scissors. Someone thinks that, why don't you take more layers at the time? It's because they are very difficult to cut out. And well, only one more, then. Well, we still have a lot of paper, but the bunch we started on. Stop with this, one more than this. And we will go and scissor some out, cut some out, clip. What we say in my country, clip them out. I think English is cut them out, I think. Or whatever. Making leaves. That's what we would do. to where we came from. With all our paper. Conversation. So, and we will go back to this camera, and put the mouse here, and we have a scissors here. So, see what can you see and what can you not see. See, I have this, and as you can see, I have put screws down this, and the reason is that when I cut these, then they all kind of stick together because the paper is so thin. But then I put the screw in and then I scramble it with a lid on. So that's why. We don't just want leaves that's nice flat like this. We want them, so I cross them afterwards a little when I have a big bunch of them in the big box. But this is to separate them, the different layers. That's the reason for that stop. One can feel that the spring and summer temperature is here because it's hot in the evening when all the light is on.
couple of months ago, it was nice when the light was on. Then there was a nice warm feeling, but now it's not that. If I clip too close down here with the, where they are stuck together, then I get a long one. But so I have to. So that I get single leaves and not a whole bunch of them in the string. I bought today is something I can use, because then I can buy some more, but that was the last one they have where in the shop where I was. This was a place where you can buy paper and office machines and print the colors and stuff like that, but we only have one of those in the city. But I guess when I have a name on that stuff, I can order it online. I get a whole carton, a whole box of it, if it's good. Oop. Is, and I guess I can get it cheaper too. At least that's the plan. And we'll see. If it works.
message from Google. I think. My Google Plus account. Say, oh, wrong mice. And go to that.
And the reason I choose this silk paper is that I want the light to go down through the tree's canopy, and this is good for that. The light can't go through it. So you get some nice color down in the forest floor, if I could say it. The light is very important for the illusion of being a real forest. So you have to plan for it up front, already up front. Because I wanted to make it avoid so much computer generated stuff as possible. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I think this gives its own feel and its own expression. to figure out what find a price on what a laser cutter cost. Keep forgetting that. That's the price of one. I could use one, not for this, but for a lot of other stuff. Figure that out one day. Look on the net for one. See how expensive they are. I don't have any idea. Always good. It's always good with some machine help when you are kind of a one man army here, like I have with the 3D printer. Need to have that guy up and running again. I have some bird I needed to print. The reason we have a little pause with that now, that is, I need to tighten all the loose ends up. It cannot help to keep on making stuff I have to finish later. Because it's only when you make the stuff that you know which problem you will run into. Because remember, all of this is just in the head to start off. When you haven't made all of this stuff before, then you don't know really what you will encounter of problems before you are in it. not good. Okay. That was the wrong one. It seems that the net are not that stable tonight. Maybe that's because all the rain. I don't know. Or maybe it's YouTube, I don't know. It keep buffering. It shouldn't do that. Because I'm looking at the stream on a laptop. And it's the only thing that is running. And there are a lot of RAM in it, so be that. It shouldn't be a problem, and it usually aren't. So something else is at play. Net provider have just updated the system. Everything should be fine. And they are usually very reliable. We have a good net in this country. And some good net providers. Because we have a lot of competition. So. And it's easy to shift from one to another if they don't live up to their promises. I know that those who live in US have a lot of problems in that regard. I understand it, that is, they don't have a lot of competition. Some areas areas they only have, can only choose between one or two providers, or some places none. Dial-ups or something like that. That's a shame. I have 120 and I can get a 300. Make a bit connection. But and I can choose myself how to make it if I want. I have 60 up and 60 down, but I can dial on it myself. I can have all of them down or all of them up, whatever I want. That's a good thing. It don't look much now, but just wait till they get separated, then it start to look better. Can we hear what Twitter up to today? The URL live.twit.tv, and now they are sending iOS today. So let's hear what they. And it's me with Leo Laporte and Megan Maroney. I don't think it started yet. It's iPad today, they have changed to and that are not good. It's nice to hear a good podcast or a netcast. Where you can learn something and the Twit network are really good at that.
Run keeper, I don't
I wonder if all those Fitbits and
Runkeeper would like to access your motion
exercise technical gadgets isn't a big illusion in our hope that we can get some solution to our
maybe it hasn't come
lack of exercising in these
look at my watch.
Computer times.
So if Atari fit my better iPhone, it's iPhone, so I'll show them the
iPhone. Some way we hope that the tech stuff can do it for us.
Magic.
but I'm afraid that
you want the hand to be
he just have to get up and move sometime. It's kind of the same as all the diets and
whoa, there you go. That's crisp as a $5 bill.
Medicine you can buy to get slimmer or lose weight. Don't really help that much.
Let me look. It's clear common.
No, So John, did you figure out my watch shot?
It's a blank weight. See, there it is. There it is. Yes, you can. So we didn't get that. Oh, see, this is the one we use, the CC010A. Is the one we use, but that's not what we want. See? Yeah.
Okay. I didn't think we ever perfected it.
Okay. How confident do you feel you can do it without destroying?
Right there?
Then you win. Because, yeah, they don't sell. They sell something a little different now.
Yeah, but...
Sideways. It looks sideways, Zach. Very good, Zach. But it looks sideways. No, you can't take it off. That's the problem.
Right. But I would put it back on like that.
Oh. What you gotta do is we're gonna have to get him to move the camera up for you as he did for me.
Yeah, I think we started and never finished the process.
Right. Isn't this fun?
Well, we would have had to do this at the other side anyway. We didn't have perfect shots up there either.
No, we sure didn't. We have to rejigger because we've got more stuff. Let's see, subsurface 3, head dropping. You need to break your arm.
Yeah.
You need the Outlander here to dislocate your shoulder.
That's fine.
Right? Yeah, but that's not ideal. Zach shouldn't have to do that every time you show your watch.
So, this is...
The CC10A is a discreet lightweight. See, this is what we use. That's what we use.
Oh.
This must be older. Oh yeah, no longer available. I bet that's what we... No.
What we... What we always want is to get a little...
No.
Number.
No. Wow, you fixed it. You double rock. Oh, I see what you did. You didn't have to remove the earpiece. You just cut the tube. Cut the tube. Well, I haven't used this in years, so... Yeah, it's yellow. It used to be clear. It's like the hose on an F-16 Phantom.
I need to see the, thank you.
See, I could wear this all day long. It's so comfy.
Now I know what was wrong. Windows was downloading updates. But I will not have them because they break my system. Last time I had to go back to restore point to fix the computer because of them. I couldn't start.
Okay, we can start.
Wirecast or anything.
Yeah, so we're not going to do a cold open until after.
So.
Okay, and then.
I guess we're just putting our best minds on this. Thank you.
Thanks, but no. I will not have it.
And we'll talk to James now.
Can I have a small fan?
Then we will do emails and voicemails.
I need a small fan right here so my wind, my hair blows.
And then we do the app cap. We don't have app cap.
You
still want to do the app cap, right?
I have whatever you and the best minds of the broadcasting think is the right thing to do. I personally like the app cap. I feel like that's a good bit.
Yeah. You see them in the rundown 24 and 46. I think you have to be logged in so I have to say.
We are getting water like
or I can just play them.
Okay, no tomorrow. I have to go a second, and now it's buffering again.
Well, if that's all we're waiting for, we can play them next week. Can you open voicemails from the sheet?
Let's see. iOS today.
We'll just save it for next week.
Is this what I need? No, because you have the rest. You got the thing that gets those into it.
It's right here.
Zooby, zooby, zoo. Oh, no, you're right. I had two clips. I don't like these. I don't know. Streamline like what? Oh, they're invisible. You can't see it. I think it's okay.
Beep, boop, boop.
Yeah, I like the funny hat.
Okay, ooh, that's much louder. That's so much better. Yeah, Burke, good job, Burke. Good job. Oh, wait. Right out of my head. Well, the problem is... No, I know, but it's really because this isn't screwed in. So it's kind of... like that, and then I can do this. Yeah, no, I know how to do this. This I know how to do. I just it the why you don't want it to go so far to the other side is the other side. Yeah, that's good. Sort
so should I do the WPA Enterprise question or not?
Well, only because Reddit is not necessarily a definitive source of Apple.
Discussion thread on the Apple.
I could find an Apple.
An Apple discussion in my friend. Sorry, I missed the link on the side.
Apple Watch. Enterprise. You notice we don't even use Enterprise here, so. Well, Apple fixes Enterprise Wi-Fi for the kitchen. iOS 8. I would think if iOS 8 worked, that the watch would work. Apparently there are issues with other stuff with Enterprise. I don't even notice anything. If I rotate this, the cable sticking out will not be as noticeable. Zooby zoo. WPA2 Enterprise and iOS 8. Seems after update of iOS 8, I can no longer connect to WPA Enterprise.
But this isn't about the watch.
Well, but it is.
But that one, that response is about the watch because it was from 2014.
Yeah, but, right, but it's related because if iOS 8 won't communicate, then the watch won't be there, obviously. Obey iOS 8.2. Attack and obtain Wi-Fi credentials. This is a WSU for Leap authentication disabled protocol. So shut down. Create a profile for Wi-Fi using the Apple configurator tool and deploying it to our iOS devices. Aha! It's more complicated. Let's see, you have to use.
No, I'm good. Thank you, though.
Apple has changed their Eat modules, the authentication route, because of a leak flaw. Correct user of the race is not able to understand the Eat messages sent by iOS 8. Sure, that's a problem with combination device. Wow, this is a very long and elaborate thread on this subject. What Leo just said, says Bill Hicks. Yeah, you have to use a configurator to use a compatible. Authentication an issue. So download the configuration tool, enter the WLAN settings, then apply the WLAN profile to the phone. Now I wonder if you fix it on the phone, does it fix it on the watch? It does. Right, that's what I thought. Right. So. Right. Leap is insecure, so they eliminate Leap. Beta release. No. So it sounds like it's more complicated than just that the Apple Watch doesn't work with it. So if you fix it on iOS 8, you should just, that's, those settings would propagate to the watch and it would work, right? I can't find anything that says that. Did Edge fall off the edge?
It did.
I know, that was like a long time ago. Last week.
In reference to this, we could fall off the edge.
But I can do it backwards, we can back.
Alright, what are we waiting for now?
So I don't have to read anything.
Not yet.
So.
No, we'll just start. Say, oh, my dad went away.
Zooby zooby zoo.
We are iOS today.
Zooby zooby zoo.
All right.
Oh, all right. You wanted to do that all day.
I did tell him at
12:19
that they were still here, so.
Yeah. I've been watching the live stream. I've been listening to these videos.
He's been here before.
Zooby
Zooby
Zoo.
So what do you think of the season ender?
No kidding.
I've only watched season one, so.
Not a bad thing.
Oh, man.
He's not a fan of The Wire.
I really miss Sarah Lane.
I am. I love The Wire. The Wire's one of the best.
I thought he said that last time you were on, he said he didn't like The Wire. It was too slow.
Oh no! I like The Wire. I think maybe what I said was that it's tough enough that I can't binge watch The Wire.
No.
That's how
I feel about Daredevil.
Just wait a week.
Okay.
That's exactly how I feel about Daredevil. It's like okay, I need a break.
Yeah, sometimes you do. Daredevil. I like Daredevil,
a lot of hand-to-hand combat.
Yeah.
In fact, now we're on episode 5 or something. seems like every episode begins with him being beaten and having to crap beat at him.
Yeah, I kind of like that in the sense that if you were a superhero or a not quite so superhero and you were in fights all the time, you would get the crap beat out of you, right? You even if you won, you would be injured and stuff. I kind of like that.
Yeah, he wins, but he wins hard.
Yeah, with broken ribs and blood and stuff like that.
Oh my god.
So, okay, so you're not a Madman fan yet. And you are a Wire fan, but not a binge one.
I like the first season of Madman, but I just haven't felt compelled to pick it back up. So it's on my to-do list.
It's Matt Weiner's kind of stubborn refusal to do anything predictable or storyline. That's right. It's a little disorienting, and it gets more so through the years.
It's a show that does not care if you like it.
It doesn't care if you like it. Exactly right. And I like that about it. But let us...
That's why I like it.
Because it doesn't care. All right. You're going to have to sit there for a little longer. I'm sorry.
All right. I've been standing here.
Thank you. You're very kind, Jason.
I appreciate it when you said, oh, no, he's very busy, as I watched you guys.
He's got lots to do. He's logging as we speak.
My email. What's up?
Said,
Jason, this is Zach on the other end. I will just keep him muted until we bring you on.
Unless, well, you can leave him up and just throw out.
I'll leave you an
exit.
How's that? Does that sound okay? Would it be sideways like that? Is that right? Yeah. Is somebody up? Somebody wrecked, as they say. China's ban of soldiers from wearing the new Apple Watch over concerns of cybersecurity, says one Chinese soldier, but my daughter made it for me. Zoom, my 10-year-old daughter.
All right.
Do I have to work on this? It's a little puzzling. I'll tell you what, I'll put it down here for the time being. And then I'll bring it up when I have to I'll show you. I'll show you my watch. Oh, but then I've lost the spot.
Oh, I lost my spot.
But it's just weird. I can do that because I can adjust it on the fly. I have eyes.
There we go. I have eyes too. Okay. All right. Are you ready?
Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm ready.
Welcome to Iowa Today.
Where are we? Where are we? I'm lost.
Our new set is beautiful. My brain is connected to your brain.
We didn't really think about that when we built the Stargate, but I'm happy about that.
Yeah, this is the show all about iOS, Apple Watch, iPhone.
What else?
The other stuff. Oh, iPad.
Apple TV. So the reason we decided to rejigger iPad today and kind of make it a little bit broader is because, well, when the Apple Watch came out, we realized, oh, well, this is kind of an artificial constraint where we can't talk about that. We can talk about this. So many apps now are on all three platforms, the iPhone, the iPad, and the Watch. And frankly, I think maybe even as soon as WWDC next month, Apple's going to announce an Apple TV that has an app store. And then suddenly you'll get an app that'll be on your iPad, your iPhone, your Apple Watch, and your Apple TV. So we need to show that covers all four iOS platforms. So that's what the show is.
Right. We call this the pantfecta. Remember the apps?
It was the trifecta.
Yeah.
Then the quadrifecta. Yeah. Now I don't know what we're going to do. Anyway. Welcome.
Yes. So today we're going to talk about Activity App. I ran the Beta Breakers race yesterday with a bunch of crazy dressed up naked people, and it was fun.
It's a it's not a marathon.
No, it's 7.6 miles.
1.725 marathon.
Yeah,
I don't know what it is.
It's from the Bay to the Breakers, from the San Francisco.
And the Hay Street Hill is the tough part.
Yeah, that's the tough part. Uphill, yeah.
But it's through beautiful San Francisco, and then people wear costumes or they don't wear anything at all sometimes.
Some people just wear running shoes.
And so the runners in the beginning are runners.
Yes.
Everybody else is the party.
Yeah.
Which part were you in?
I ran. We took the ferry in, and then we were a little bit late for the start, but it was clear then. Usually you're at the start and you can't run at all because you're just in the crowd.
Yeah.
But yeah, we ran the whole way.
And were you in a caterpillar?
I wasn't. I was in a group.
A lot of leaves.
They sometimes shoot it, they run in groups and they're all one kind of thing.
But I was in the group with other cluckers also.
Aw, and so you were wearing feathers?
Feathers.
So you look like chickens?
Yes.
Running
around? Yes.
How fun.
Yes.
And what was your time?
1:30.
And how do you know that?
I know it from my watch.
Oh, what a segue!
So yeah, I had the Apple Watch. I used the built-in Apple Watch.
The activity
monitor and the workout
monitor. So I use it too, but I don't run. So if you show me yours,
So the activity app is really interesting. I have it right there on the face of my watch.
But they will look beautiful on the trees. I think. Hope.
And that shows my move and my, exercise goals and everything. For the run, I use the workout app, which is the one with the little.
That's a little confusing. So there's the activity tracker, that's the circles that Apple made a big deal about, and then this workout tracks workouts.
Right. So when you start, you just decide you're going to do the run. So this was what I did. I did 7.6 miles, and then you put a goal in there.
So that's one thing that I noticed right away is that you can say I want a goal, target heart rate, distance, calorie burn, or you can just say it's an open run. What I want you to do is tell me at the end of the run how much I did.
Yeah.
So then that's what you chose.
Yeah, and I started it and stopped. I really like the activity app, and it comes on you don't normally have it on your watch. I mean, on your phone. You don't have a watch.
As soon as you install the watch, it says, oh, and it puts activity tracking.
Right, and so
I didn't know there was an app on my phone.
Yeah, I didn't either. And
you pull up yours, and I'm going to show you mine, okay?
Okay.
Because I actually had some activity.
Oh, you did it.
Amazing thing.
On your Segway?
So this is... They don't think that counts. So that's the circle. Notice, by the way, excellent circle-ish. And when you do a workout, the red ring will show your workout. The green ring shows, what is the green ring? Red ring is, calorie goal. So I have 500 a day is my goal. The green ring is how many minutes of exercise. And then, remember that thing where it warns you to stand up every time?
Yeah.
But as with you, I actually use the workout app. This little green man here. And you choose which exercise. It's kind of a fairly good selection.
So you added some. I don't have stair steppers. I think you added that.
I didn't add it, but maybe it noticed I was doing a lot of stair steppers. Actually, that's kind of an unfair thing. The stair stepper was when I was helping Abby move out of the dorm room. She was on the third floor. And I realized, wait a minute, you can actually use this for stair stepping. So you see here, you can set your calorie burn. That's the last time I did it. You can set your minutes. So it gives you, or you can do it open.
I do have stairs.
I did, yeah. I think there's a pretty good selection. Again, this is the one I just did. But if you decide open, watch what it does. It's kind of fun. You feel like you're actually in a race. Beep, 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 boom. And you start, and you can see I'm burning the calories even as I am sitting here. And then when you're done, by the way, as you run, it will show you this stuff. And did it beep you every mile?
It's supposed to notify you. Yes, it did. I got the wrist notification.
Yeah,
and
I think that's
kind
of cool. So you know how many miles you've done.
And you can see more on the phone. I had it.
Get awards on the phone.
I got achievements. I did 1,000 steps. Don't show my password. Okay, now can you see my phone? Is this a good place for it?
That's definitely not a good place. You don't use the iPad camera much. We have four cameras over our shoulders. There you go!
I can go to yesterday. So see how much activity I went around and around in the circle for yesterday. And it shows you what time you burned the most calories. And then, of course, with the watch, it's also here my achievements.
Congratulations on some marvelous achievements.
So that's my...
What is that? Slinky from the top down?
It's a sticker. I wore heat. She calls them stickers, so that's what I call them, stickers. She loves stickers. She's a psychologist, so she's a doctor.
So she understands the gamification. So,
but we have her and I talked about this, because I...
What is that? I've never seen that.
I used 300% of my goal.
Oh, I would never see that. I like this. This is what, I remember Foursquare did this, and it did give you badges.
Yeah.
So I've got some, I thought these awards were a little odd, these kind of little weird 3D stars.
Where'd you get that one?
For a first stair stepper workout, right? I like this. You can see the calendar of how you've done each day. So that, to me, this is all motivational. The idea is by doing, you know, seeing this, you're more likely to actually, you know, do some exercising. And it has had that effect. I mean, yeah, these are silly achievements. But on the other hand, when you get one, don't you feel kind of good?
What
Captain America wields his mighty shield.
If you didn't get one, would you not do the exercise? That's the question. Because is it like, oh, well, if I'm not going to get the sticker,
no, then I'm not going to. To me, what it really, the real benefit of it is, before you exercise, when you have an exercise, you can look at that calendar and look at the gym and go, oh, I really should exercise. You know what? It's not a push. It's not even a nudge. It's just a little tap. And that's enough. Sometimes you just go, oh, yeah, I should do it. It's a little tap-tick nudge.
Yeah, I like it. Well, you know, and I don't know if you know the answer to this question. Later on, we're going to talk to Jason Snell. He's going to give us some more Apple Watch tips. Might not know the answer. Can you get the activity app if you don't have a watch?
Oh, good question. I don't think so.
Okay.
Because it's
all
automatically to get the watch.
That's the way it is.
Yeah.
Alright, but this is just the stuff that comes with the phone. Can you add stuff to the phone?
You can. I can show some stuff.
Okay. Oops.
Phone and watch. Runkeeper. Do you use Runkeeper?
I've used a couple other running apps on the boat here.
One of the things Runkeeper has done is integrated with other things. So I don't run, but I can bicycle and stuff like that. And so it integrates with a lot of other apps, as they say, services and devices. It integrates with my Fitness Pal, which I use to track up. See that? It's kind of bright, isn't it? Let me just turn down the brightness.
So I don't shoot over the target.
I integrate it in with my Fitness Pal, which we're going to show a little bit later on. That's how I can track my food. Now, Apple Health, someday there will be an Apple Health. And when there is, Apple Health is the overall Apple app. It's like Passbook. It's going to keep track of all of this stuff.
Keeping track of it now?
It is.
It keeps track of my heart rate.
Apparently, if, yeah.
Sure. And another one.
So I'm going to allow Runkeeper to write calories, cycling distance, height, walk. I'm going to turn it all on. You have to enable it. I'm in health kit right now. Date of birth. I'm going to get to the same. Runkeeper, you can have it all. And so now I've connected to health. So when I do a run, Runkeeper keeps track of it. It all goes into health kit. Similarly, Runkeeper, of course, shows up on the watch as well. And so I can look at the watch and see how I'm doing on my Runkeeper. You know, one of these days I'm going to stop tapping these little mini icons and use Siri to launch stuff. There it is. So now if I want to go running, instead of using workout, I could just tap go running. And it talks to me, which is kind of nice. It's a little simpler, right?
It is.
Yeah. Notice it said activity, because Runkeeper, even despite the name, doesn't want it really just be for runs.
Yeah, and it really spoke to you.
It spoke.
So, okay, so you were saying Health Kit. Now, I think the one with the heart, yeah, that's just the Apple Health app.
I paused.
And Health Kit is the one that's going to eventually be around, right? That will connect.
Yeah.
Your cancer and all that?
No, that's research kit.
Oh, research.
Health Kit does not cure cancer. Research Kit cures cancer.
Well,
no,
I don't
think none of their cancer.
Say that. It helps.
Right.
Gather data and use large amounts of data.
But that's important because I think people might have heard about Research Kit and said, is my stuff going to the Mayo Clinic? It's not.
You have to
sign up and make this big thing. So feel free to use Health Kit. It's just a separate. Thank you. Yes, I'm done.
That was a good workout.
Yeah.
You're done. I'll eat a hamburger.
I'm amazed he even came up with that number. It's really an infinite amount of time.
Yeah, that was like your
toe
tapping.
that's Runkeeper integrating, which integrates the Health Kit app with Runkeeper.
And now the PowerPoint.
It does it on the watch too, which is kind of nice.
Yeah.
What else? So do you use it for running?
I don't. Yeah, maybe I should.
I think it's a good app. It's certainly the kind of the dominant leader.
Well, the app that I use instead is Zombie Run, which
that's how I run.
I like to be chased by zombies.
This
I'm
is
running.
So cool.
So you can listen to your own music, and this is free to download. download with in-app purchases. You listen to your own music. You can have a playlist of music or podcasts or whatever. And then you just press start your mission, but I don't know if we'll be able to hear that.
Start moving now. Choose your own path. We will never ask you to change direction. We'll deal with the rest later. Right now, let's get going.
So that's kind of deceptive. It feels like, oh, there's just an eye coming. Yeah. Gonna work. No. Wait a minute.
I don't know how they live like that either. So what it is it's training you to, I mean, you're just running and you run, they're not telling you where to go. You just run, but then it tells you to speed up because it's just, you know, a zombie is chasing you and so you run really fast.
It doesn't make you jump over fences.
Yeah.
It doesn't say, quick, run down the middle of the street screaming zombies.
No.
Go save them.
Worry,
it's just a story.
About
it's entertaining in this radio broadcast and all sorts of
right.
things.
Right.
It's kind of cool.
Because that's the way you're supposed to run, I think. It's, you know, slow and then fast.
Right,
intervals. Intervals, absolutely. Yeah, so, it's cool. I like it, and then it tracks your runs too. And
we mentioned MyFitnessPal. I should probably show that. So this is another app. A lot of people love this app that lets you keep track of calories you've eaten. It's awfully bright. If it reverts, or maybe this is a particularly bright app. It's social, really great. As is RunKeeper, it allows, for instance, Dr. Mom, who I'm in constant contact with, she's kind of saying, I lost 5 pounds. She said, good job. I see what she's doing. People have blog posts. So I like the social aspect of this because, you know, I think we know this, that if exercise is better, if you're doing it with somebody else, if maybe you've got a challenge. So it's exercise, it's keeping track. Lisa's doing her food diary right now. The one person who doesn't keep a food diary, but it's fun and it's very easy. You know, if I'm going to add a food, there it is. Wait, it's dark again. You can turn it up a little bit so you can see it. So it knows what you've had before, and I'm going to have it again. I had an espresso this morning, a little cream, got some tangerines, and almond butter, that kind of thing. It'll add that all up. It seems to be a little sluggish right now. Keeps track of all of that, but look at this. This is the watch interface. Let me do it right. Hey, Siri, open my fitness pal. That's a little tip, by the way. It's always easier to do that than try to find that little tiny icon in Siri. Now I have to hold my wrist up higher because you panned up a little bit. So, shows what you consumed and how many of your daily total is available. It also gives you nutrient breakdown, which is kind of cool. You can see how much fat, carbs, fiber, sugar. And by the way, on this app, you can set your limits. So if you don't care about fat or you don't care about carbs, you can say, I don't care. You know, you can tell it. It also keeps track, and this is nice. All of these apps do this. They're integrating in the steps that I take from my watch, from my phone. So it's keeping track of that, and you get to decide which app you're going to use. So the calories that I burn up, and at least it does do this, burn up in whatever app you use. If you use MyFitnessPal, it'll automatically record that.
Right.
That's actually really great.
It is great. Before you had to guess, you know, you said, I walked 2 miles, I probably burned, I don't know, 1,000 calories. Like,
right.
You just put that in there. Now it's
I apologize, apparently I've launched, we're going to call it Shlomo. I launched Shlomo on a bunch of our live viewers. I should warn you when I'm going to say,
hey, Shlomo.
But
not the watch. Shlomo. I thought you were going to do it with the watch. For the watch, you have to press it down.
No, you don't. Watch. Hey, Shlomo. All you have to do is...
You're not launching it on mine, then.
Well, if it were listening...
My watch never pays attention.
It never listens. Hey, Shlomo, I'm talking to you. Oh, I have to say that other word.
On MyFitnessPal, you can take pictures of the barcodes of food.
I didn't mention that, but that's a nice feature. I try not to eat packaged food, so that's the most valuable feature for me. But yeah, if you eat packaged food, it's very simple. And they have a lot of restaurant menus too. So when you go to Wendy's and you have that extra crunchy burger with bacon, you know it's going to be in there. Unfortunately, it's going to register all those calories on your MyFitnessPal.
Yes. I have one more app.
All right.
And then we can.
I have one more too.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
This is called Charity Miles. This is one I use. Can I turn this like this? Because it's only. I don't actually use it on my iPad, but I thought it'd be easier to show it on my iPad.
Yeah,
because
the phone is small.
When it's attached to me when I'm running. But this app will keep track of your runs and also donate money to the charity of your choice for every.
Nice.
So it's 25 cents for every mile that you bike. No, every mile that you run or walk, 10 cents for every mile that you bike. So you get to go
through. Yeah, you shouldn't get as much money.
Right. So you go through, and this is all ads for, that's where the money's coming from. So you can choose from all these different charities, leukemia, lymphoma, society, ASPCA, Habitat for Humanity, Autism Speaks, Girls on the Run, which is a great program, and then you can say, you go on a run, and then it tracks how many miles you're doing, and it'll show you an ad, that's your free money. And and then you stop it at the end, and then you give the money to charity, or the advertisers have given money to charity, and you've just gone running. So it's good, it's inspiring to run.
Isn't it though? I really enjoyed the zombie run, and this is one you told me about, and we're going to see if we get this to work. You were having a little trouble. This is an iPhone app called Atari Fit. It comes from Atari, the game manufacturer. So it's the same idea. You would use this. Maybe I'll use this on our treadmill. You can choose. It's free, but there's in-app purchases. So if you say, oh, I want to do a gym workout, you can subscribe to a gym workout, but watch. There's a buy button. And so, you know, this is a lot of apps. Like Fit Start, do this, you buy the plan.
That's how zombie runs use it.
Yeah, that's fun. I understand that. But let's track a run. Oops. I'm gonna allow it to use my location. Okay. I'm gonna say I'm running right now. Okay. And then I can play Atari games, but did you see what it said? I have to earn some coins by actually running. So don't you love this? This incentivizes you. Here's Centipede, Pong, and Super Breakout. If I earn 5 points, I can play a classic Atari game. I think that's so cool.
It is. It's gamifying it, too. It's like, if you don't go for the stickers, maybe you want to play Atari.
This is what you were having it crash.
Yeah, it was crashing.
This is brand new. It's not, relatively, just came out a couple of months ago. I'm not sure if it's because we're using this on iPads or what, or maybe because I have no coins. Are you ready? For a little Pong while you run. Anyway, worth trying. It's free to download. We've had a few bugs, a few force crashes, but I love that idea. Play old vintage games while I work. And the truth is, I can't play a fancy game. I need simple games. Pong's perfect because I'm doing this, right?
Yeah. And so it's for when you are running. Like.
Yeah, but it wouldn't be for when you're running down the street. It would be for. Well, no, you could do it. No, actually, you're right. You could go for a run. Then sit down and play a nice little game of Pong. But for me, I'm going to earn the coins and then I'm going to play one on the treadmill because I'm bored.
You're playing right now.
I am.
You can get all the links to all of these apps at iOS today, twitch.tv/iOS today.
All right.
A quick reminder, we're live around 12:30 Pacific time every Monday.
naturebox.com/twit. Get
get your free trial right now.
All right. Well, all part right. of the new format of the iOS today is we're going to have some guests. So it's not just us blabbing about all things we know or don't know.
Pick my favorite guest of all.
Yes. Well, Jason filled in for
He's
you.
He's been sitting in a soundproof room.
Yeah.
He filled in on the iPad today.
Yeah, we did. Yes. And so Jason now is, of course, a Mac expert.
Was he behind this?
He lives so far away that we thought that we would get him through the video calling, the Skype.
Hey, Jason.
Hello.
Nice
Hello,
to see you.
Internet.
It's good to be here. Former editor-in-chief at Mac World and editor of the Richard IDG. He's now at sixcolors.com. But he also, as you can tell from if you're watching the video, he has a very professional setup. He does a bunch of podcasts too, like The Incomparable and TheIncomparable.net.
So I bought a microphone.
What's that? That's a Shure. That's like a professional radio microphone.
I'm apparently a professional podcaster now, and I thought I ought to look them for.
Don't ask Howard Stern what he thinks about that, but okay.
So Jason, you were going to give us some Apple Watch. Yes, your first one was going to be about the Activity app, so you were listening in. Did we say anything that was not correct?
No, I think it's funny for people. People need to know that it exists, right? Because it actually doesn't appear, I think, until you pair a watch. So it's like a stealth app update. So I didn't even know. Somebody was telling me about stuff they found in the Activity app, and I said, what Activity app? And sure enough, it was there. I just had completely missed its existence. So it's good to know. I mean, tip number one is know that it exists.
No, because I think I asked Jason or somebody on MacBreak Weekly, how do I want to see my awards, my achievements, where I see them. They said, in the Activity app. I said, no. They said, on the phone. I said, what? So, yeah, you can go a while without knowing that it exists.
And in fact, one of my tips, separate from the Activity app, is about the Apple Watch app, which I think it's easy to take for granted. You get it set up and you're using your Apple Watch and you don't think about it. But the Apple Watch app is your friend. I think it's really important for people. You should explore the Apple Watch app because a lot of settings can be set in the Apple Watch app that can't be set on the watch. Some of them can, some of them can't. It's worth exploring because you will discover some things in that app. You'll be like, oh, I had no idea I could set this. And there's different like text and display settings. There's app settings. What stuff shows up as your glances? Which stuff shows up in the app switcher? So many different options. That's the heart and soul of the Apple Watch in terms of customizing it. It's actually the Apple Watch app on the iPhone.
So it's another one of those apps that didn't show up till you had iOS 8.3. As soon as you did. Yeah, and I have to say, that's the worst icon ever. It's a sideways Apple Watch.
Yeah, it is. I agree completely.
You need this. I mean, you need it, of course, to set up your watch. And every app that you have on your phone that copied over to the watch, even the ones that didn't, every app on your phone that has a watch interface will show up here, right?
Exactly.
So this is your opportunity to decide if you want Amazon. See, this is risky because you can actually buy Amazon stuff on your watch.
Yeah, it's
dangerous.
Shop by voice and then say, click it. Wow. You know what I love is Dark Sky. I do Dark Sky on my watch. You know what I found the other day that was really great is it was raining and I'm driving and it says, don't worry, it's only going to rain for 12 more minutes. I thought, that's great.
Was it true? Was it accurate?
Yeah. Dark Sky actually was one of the things Dark Sky does is it says exactly what's the weather to the moment and how much longer it's going to last. And it shows up on your watch, which is really cool.
That's how you set the friends too. You know, when you single click the side button, right? That's
right.
The first thing that comes up is your friends, and you have to set those.
Now notice I've got it turned on as an app, but I have it turned off in glances. Jason, when should I put it in glances?
I mean, we don't know how everybody's going to use this stuff quite yet. I'm trying to have a few glances rather than having, since you have to swipe through them one by one, having
right.
a lot of glances is kind of inconvenient. But if you use it a lot, it's like apps you put in your dock on your iPhone. It's like the stuff that's the most important that you're going to be checking all the time. I think, you know, putting five or six of those in as glances is good, but you don't want 20 glances, I think.
Right, I'm showing. That, I agree with you 100%. In fact, that's some of the triage that you do as you watch over a period of time. You start to turn off notifications because if it's too noisy, it's not useful. You start to turn down and show my watch it.
The fingers. Start to disintegrate with all that clipping.
This is, I keep this right up front. You can rearrange glances in the app, right? So I keep this up front because I listen to audiobooks. So when I'm playing it, I love this. When I'm playing an audible book on here, it will show Snell, I did not know that. I've been trying to do this with my little tip of my finger. This is so much easier. And I do like to pause it. And on Audible, this, it must be picking up, you know, pieces from Audible, even though there's no Audible watch app. It knows that Audible can jump back 30 or forward 30, so it adds that functionality.
Well, it does with Pandora, you can also...
It'll do that too?
Yeah, okay. If you don't want to use the Pandora app, you want to use the Now Playing app. You told me that too, Jason, because then you can control it.
It's the same API that they use. You get those buttons on the lock screen of the iPhone, and it's very clever that they change based on whether you have a jump back set or a jump forward set. Okay. That's what you see in there.
So,
and it's just,
oh dear, yes. Put them in the big box. See how many there is when you take them apart.
And listen to music and control it via the Now Playing glance or the music app on the watch. So it's not something that you would think would be possible. Why would you want that? But it's actually great. That means that if you want to.
And there are even more. Put that on the floor.
Really easily from the latest app you're using. for a minute, and then you look, and you're back at the watch face. You're like, oh, I don't want to go out and launch that app again. Just double tap.
Oh, that's brilliant. Right, really, because I was conflicted. I, on the one hand, I kind of wanted to set that setting so it would show the clock every time. On the other hand, I kind of like to be able to jump to the app. I was, so now you can. You can have it automatically back to the clock when you raise your wrist. But double tap to get back to the last app.
There are a few cases where you'd want, I think, to have the app always stay open, but they're, I think they're limited. Like, there are remotes for PowerPoint and Keynote.
That's what
if you're presenting, you should go in, you can actually go into the settings app on the watch and change it on the fly. That's the kind, that's the time where you really want it to always be on the watch, or on the app, so that you can just look at your watch and tap next and move to the next slide. But almost every other case...
Then tomorrow night we can get a lot of tree spills.
You know, if you look,
that's a good thing.
Face. And you can always get back to that app by double tapping on the ground.
Settings, general, this is on the watch, settings, general, and then activate on wrist raise. You can say when it's on raise, you're just waiting to watch the display when it's off, and wait to display by tapping it. And then choose what do I want to resume to clock face. Or I did try it with latitude tap for a while, and I said, no, but I really mostly want to see the card. And now I understand why they offer that for a PowerPoint. It makes a lot of sense.
It makes a lot of sense if you need immediate access without looking.
Right.
They kind of unwind sometimes.
I think you leave that setting turned off, and I wonder if at some point they'll allow third-party developers to set a default for that. Like, so like if I leave the Keynote app open, it will know to stay open, and if I leave, you know, something else open, it knows, oh, it doesn't matter. We'll see, but you can set that globally right now.
This double tap. Oh, this is so. The other thing that always bugs me is that I'm in something. And I want to see the clock. When I tap the crown once, it always brings me to the clock. It usually brings me back to this.
Yes.
And then I tap it again, it centers on the clock, and I have to do that. But if I double tap, it'll always be bring me back to the clock.
That's the idea. It's just toggling between the watch face and the app that you're using.
Save me some squinting.
Yeah. All right, you have one last tip about passcode.
Yes. Yeah, so this is speaking of weird things that apps can do if they're from Apple. and also about this thing where, you know, very cleverly to save battery life, it goes to sleep. The Passbook app on the watch is a little bit different. And if you haven't noticed it, this is kind of a cool thing. If you open Passbook and you scroll to a barcode, when you reach the barcode, something happens. The background drops away. The brightness on your watch goes to 100%. And if you put your wrist away from you, it doesn't go to sleep, at least not for a while. And this is very clever, because you can imagine a kind of a comedy routine where you're trying to scan something at the store.
I've done that comedy.
And you reach your wrist out, and it turns off, and you're like, oh, let me get it back on. And then you reach it back out, and it turns back on.
Or you're at the airport, where you want to show that QR code to TSA.
Exactly.
The last thing you want to do is go, well, no, wait a minute, hold on. And then you have to... So that's good to know.
Zany comedy routine, but in Passbook, it's smart enough because Apple has access to this and third-party developers don't. It cranks up the brightness, drops away the background, and makes the auto sleep. Behave differently so that you've got time to scan that barcode from your Starbucks card or your boarding pass from, you know, from your airline or anything like that, or a ticket for a baseball game, same sort of deal. It works pretty well. You'd be surprised on that little tiny screen. The barcodes do generally scan about as well as they do on a phone.
Have you used it at the airport yet?
I have not used it at the airport because the scanner that I ran into at the airport for my boarding pass was angled so that it was just like this little tiny space where you could slip a piece of paper under or a phone, but there's no way I could get my whole wrist under there. Just the geography of it, or geometry of it, really didn't work. I did buy a tea at Starbucks using it though.
Yeah.
So, and that was at the airport. Airport Starbucks. So
you used it?
Yeah, pretty much the same.
Yeah.
And I did use Apple Pay to buy a hot dog at the baseball game on my watch, which was pretty awesome.
That is. I'm loving it. At the grocery store, I was a little bit nervous, but I started doing it. No one's making fun of me; they're all amazed. And
I've been using it. I've been using it as well. I wish it were, and this is really a function of my own credit cards. Fewer steps. I would love it if I just show the watch and they say, "Thank you, you paid." But unfortunately, I still have to go through
you know, you are, with this Apple Pay stuff, you are authenticating with your body, right? So you shouldn't need to sign because you're, you know, it being strapped to your wrist, it reading your thumbprint, these are authentications as good as a signature, but right now our infrastructure is sort of not capable of making the distinction, and I'm hoping that this fall, when the new chip credit cards come in, that maybe the this digital payment experience will improve too.
Well, Jason, thank you so much. I know you have a lot of podcasts. I read on Twitter that you just did one that was highly edited, like a story style.
I did, actually. People, if people are interested in David Letterman retiring...
I am. His last 3 days, yeah.
Or you're wondering why people are talking about David Letterman retiring and why it matters, the latest edition of The Incomparable, which you can get to at theincomparable.com, is called Monkey Cam. And it is, I interviewed about 5 people and told sort of my own story about the significance of this and put it all together into a pretty nice, I think, I'm really happy with how it turned out. And it's a departure because it is more like something you hear on NPR than just a round table. But it was a lot of fun to do, and he's one of my kind of comedy idols, I suppose you'd say. He very, very made a serious impression on how I view writing and irony and comedy and senses of humor at a young age. And it's his last week on the air, so I wanted to do something special, so that was it.
Me too. Very much influenced my presentation style on TV. Really sad to see him go. I can't wait to read that. Thank you, Jason.
Thanks,
Jason. Jason Snell, everybody. Well, now what do we do?
Well, we have another sponsor.
Keeper of the Rundown. Gazelle?
Yes.
I have to admit, the watch is growing on me. People are noticing that I'm wearing the watch more and more. And I had to get an iPhone 6 to go with the watch. Callie Lewis, same thing. She had only Samsung phones. Gazelle.com, that's where you go if you want to trade in your existing gadget to get a new gadget. Gazelle will buy your old iPhones, your old iPads, your Samsung, your BlackBerry, your LG, your Motorola phones, tablets from all the big manufacturers, including Google and Microsoft, Samsung, and of course Apple. It's a great place to sell. If you go there right now, you'll get a guaranteed 30-day locked-in price. That's nice, because you don't have to decide. I'm waiting for the LG G4 phone, but I don't know if I'm going to get it, but I'd love to get a quote, and you should get a quote right now on your old phone, because after all, it's not going up in price. You might wonder what happens to those devices when Gazelle buys them. Well, some of them they recycle, of course. Some of them they sell elsewhere, but the very best stuff they sell right there at Gazelle.com. Yes, Gazelle now has a certified pre-owned program. Devices are available in 2 conditions. They're certified like new. It's basically new. Certified good devices will show some gentle signs of wear, but in every case, every device has been put through a rigorous third-party inspection, so they're fully functional. You're always backed by a 30-day risk-free return policy. These guys are great. Gazelle is a great company. They'll buy your old stuff. They'll sell your replacement stuff or new stuff. Free shipping. Most items qualify for a free box. Fast processing. And cash. Via check or a PayPal credit if you want. Or an Amazon gift card. It is a great way to sell and a great way to buy. Gazelle.com. Since we talk a lot about these shiny new gadgets, make sure you dispose of them responsibly. At Gazelle. And get a little cash in your pocket.
So should we answer a few emails?
I'm ready.
All right. Mark writes, my father has left his iPad multiple times in the grocery store, in the home building supply store, and other places.
No.
My question is, if there's something you can attach to it to make it beep or text his phone when he moves away from it?
It's
Mark from Oregon.
I mean, there are external things that you could attach, certainly.
A leash?
There's companies that make beepers. In fact, there have been a number of Kickstarter programs to do that. It would sure be nice, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's a Find My Phone feature that will beep it so you know where it is, right?
That's one of the things I like about the Apple Watch is when I can't find my phone, I press the little button that says Find My Phone, and it beeps my phone. It makes a loud noise on my phone, pinging the phone, and then the phone goes bing, 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 bing.
Even if you have it silenced.
Even if it's silenced, which my phone, of course, is, and the nice thing about that is it's really good for finding the phone. So fun. But that doesn't solve our problem because he's leaving it behind and doesn't know he's leaving it behind.
Right. He wants to know that he's leaving it behind before he gets far away.
Yeah, I mean, well, I've left a few tablets in the seat back of an airplane. And once you go through security, I will forever have a good opinion of the TSA. You know, everybody hates those people who search you. I will forever have a good opinion because the TSA guy says, okay, I'm getting off, but I'll go back and check. And brought her back her iPad from the plane, even though we were outside the sanitized zone.
Yeah.
There are TRACKR tracker, but it's an external device, so you're gonna have to get a loop or a hook or something to put on the tracker device. To attach the tracker device to your pad, but it certainly will do that. What you do is you install the tracker app on your iPhone, and then if it breaks the connection via Bluetooth with the tracker device, it'll make a big loud noise. It'll ring at you. Works with the Android and the iPhone. These are what the little tracker devices look like here. This is the tracker.
I'm Chris.
Hi, Chris. Hi, Chris. I don't care about Christian, but if we can just get them to show their... Oh, my head's in the way? All right. The device is actually... The new tracker is really small. Let's see if I can skim through this a little bit. Now you get the idea. It's, there it is. You see it on that briefcase? It's just like... It's about a dog tag size. Right? So if you probably would want a case for your iPad that you put it in. And then that case would have the tracker attached to it. Somebody should make a tracker case.
That would be
kind of interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, that's one of many. There are a lot of them, but I know about that one because I've done that. I think that was a good start.
I have another question from, this one is from Kathy. We were talking about this if you were watching the pre-show. She writes, I'm thrilled that you're changing the focus of iPad today to iOS today.
Thank you
for doing this.
Yeah.
Also wanted to let you know that the Apple Watch does not currently work with WPA Enterprise 2 network. I was not aware of this, and I think other people may want to check out the type of Wi-Fi that exists at their place of employment.
A lot of businesses use it. We recommend WPA encryption as the safest way to protect your Wi-Fi. It means nobody can use your Wi-Fi access spot, and nobody can see the traffic that's flying through the air. We usually use WPA Personal. In fact, even here we're using WPA Personal. But I did a little research on WPA Enterprise. Well, I asked Jeff to tell me I did the research. And it is true that even iOS 8 had a problem.
And here's the next one.
On iOS 8, when it came out, the Leap authentication protocol was disabled because it was found to be insecure. There was a problem with it. So Apple turned it off. If that's the default protocol being used on your iPad, it's not going to work. It's not going to authenticate. But you can go into, there's a program you can download that will allow you to configure your enterprise Wi-Fi settings on the iPad. Your IT department will know about it. And make it work, once again, by changing the settings. We haven't tried this, but we believe that when you do that on your iPhone, it will automatically propagate the new authentication protocol to your watch, and everything should be okay. So, if you work in a workplace where they use WPA2 enterprise encryption on Wi-Fi, many businesses do, they already will know about this issue. This Leap protocol is no longer being used. The tool that they use, you can use to configure your iPhone. So now, if your iPhone can get on the corporate network, it's my understanding, my belief, that your watch will be able to. So the key is get your iPhone on it first. That's my thought. You know, I'd love to. If somebody has a different experience, please email us. We can't test it here because we don't use Enterprise.
Right.
Personally.
Yeah. So the email address is still iPad Today, as it does to be. We will be changing that soon. But for now, iPad Today.
If I'm ever going to make another stop-motion movie,
yeah,
it will be in the desert.
I
think. And one single lizard.
I don't know why that would be, because so the way the watch works, my understanding is it uses Bluetooth most of the time. But once it has a high bandwidth,
it would have
like
been easier.
Communication to make with the phone, I'll switch to Wi-Fi. That should work. Maybe it's just something about my Wi-Fi phone. But yeah, every time I try to answer the phone on my watch, if the phone's not nearby, I can't.
I always keep my phone nearby. Yesterday when I was at the Beta Breakers, left my house at 5 a.m., the battery on my phone
that's
ran out.
That's not the story I wrote, so...
I have been very happy, I have to say.
There is no way around it.
Well, and the watch, but one thing I do notice The watch isn't going to have to worry so much about this because it's just talking phone to phone nearby. But when you get to some areas like San Francisco, who's your carrier?
Sprint.
I noticed that there's a lot of hunting going on, and there are areas where the radio on your phone is working overtime to keep you connected, and that's when the battery dies. Walking around Petaluma, you don't have any problem, right?
No.
I don't even use half of the battery on my iPhone 6 in a normal day. But going downtown San Francisco, because there's a lot of handoff, a lot of hunting, a lot of searching, the buildings get in the way, you're inside, your crazy centipede costume is blocking the signal. That's why your phone doesn't always have the same battery life.
Yeah.
In San Francisco, I've noticed that. It can just go away. I've been through a lot of cities.
But it was one of those moments where, like, I was going to use my watch to call Uber. I was going to impress all my friends with my battery.
Frustrating.
Yeah, but...
Because it won't do it by itself.
No. But I could have paid for something with it by itself.
You know what I don't do when I go to San
Francisco? What?
My clothes. I love the clothing store in San Francisco, but they just, I don't shop.
You don't shop?
Well, I shop.
Fancy. How do you not shop and dress so fancy?
What a lie. I don't like to shop for clothes. I love to shop for gadgets, obviously. You take me to a Fry's, I'll go there all day shopping for gadgets. But when it comes to clothes shopping, I'm very glad I found Trunk Club. This is one of my beautiful Merino wool Trunk Club sweaters. The way this works is you sign up for Trunk Club, trunkclub.com/quit. At this point, you pay nothing, and you will continue to pay nothing. You will talk to your personal stylist. Well, personal stylist, she's great. I told her all about my style. She says, what brands do you buy? Where do you like to shop? Do you like to send me pictures of yourself so I can see your coloring. I can see how you like to dress. Maybe this isn't how you currently dress. What would your aspirational wardrobe be like? She was great. I mean, really, it was like talking to a psychotherapist for an hour. That was not happening. Then, even better, she put online on a website. I don't have it anymore. I can show you, but I don't have it. A website with people you like this about. It's like hot or not or something. No, I don't want that. Yes, I want that. No, I don't want that. Then, I got my trunk. I'm going to show you a trunk. Sometimes the boxes are much bigger than this. It depends on how much you're getting. But the Trunk Club trunk comes with all sorts of incredible clothes in it. By the way, I still haven't paid a penny. All right? I'm going to pay, but only for the stuff I keep for my trunk. So first I have to figure out how to get into it. Oh, here it is.
Here.
It's just I don't know where what I'm doing. I'll show you. Look at this. Now, you can help me. Do you like this?
I do, yeah.
See, I think Marco would love this. It's not available. I'm sorry. No, it's kind of lumberjack. So I don't. That's fine. No big deal. You only. What do you think about this? You like this? This is kind of neat.
A couple things there. The jacket is nice.
This is nice. This is kind of an unstructured.
Ooh, is that a shirt?
Jacket. No, it's a jacket. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
I should put it on. This I love, and I'm definitely gonna keep this. This is a cable knit sweater. You know, I like the cable knits. Anyway, you go through the trunk. You put aside what you want. You pile the rest back into the trunk. You send the trunk back. Only thing you pay for ever is the stuff you keep. You don't pay for shipping. You don't pay for the stylist's time. You can get as many trunks as you want. Keep nothing. You'll never pay anything. You only pay for the clothes you keep. And by the way, this is not a subscription. Don't fear that you're going to get a trunk every month and forget to cancel it and have to pay. No, it doesn't work that way. You only get a trunk when you ask for it. You only pay for the clothes you keep. You've got 10 days to try it. It is the best way to shop, guys. Look, I know you want to maybe upgrade your look. You want to get a better job. You want to get a better girlfriend. Trunkclub.com. I shouldn't say that. Maybe you want to get a better boyfriend. Let's not be judgmental here. Trunkclub.com/twit. Maybe you just want to get a better pet. Pets care how you dress.
They really
do. They notice. They say, it's just not taking the trouble you used to. Trunkclub.com/twit. I love it. And I do not like to shop for clothes. That's why it's...
Who goes first, me or you?
Golly, I don't know, Mrs. Crowley.
Do you use RDO? $0.99 a month. But here's what you get. You get 25. You don't get unlimited music. You want to hear what you do get?
Yeah, what do I get? I asked the wrong question.
You get...
Megan, what do I get?
You get unlimited ad-free streaming stations.
Oh.
Stations like Pandora. Unlimited skits.
Unlimited skits?
Yeah.
Even
and
Pandora won't do that.
Well, I know. And you can download 25 songs per day. So that once you've reached your 25 song limit, if you want to download another one, you can, but then the last... No, that day.
Is it a range
the most recent?
How about the next day? Can I get another 25
and yes. 50? Yes, you have 25 at once.
Oh, ever.
No man can listen to more than 25 songs.
In a day? Never. No one could do that.
$3.99. I think this is a good option for kids.
No,
more allowance.
Basically, how I use Arneo. I don't think I would use any more.
Yeah, because 10, you can still use the regular.
I can use the one song in there.
Yeah, I think 25 is a good, you know, it's like a playlist.
Well,
yeah.
That's 100 minutes of the song performance.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. What, I mean, you have a
who has time to listen to more than 100 minutes?
So, yeah, I mean, it's pretty, you know, you just...
The thing about RDO on the iPad is a great interface. It really is. And the social, like, you get all the other stuff, you just get limited on the number of tracks
yeah.
you can.
Right. Also, you know, you can add this one, and I'm going to download it to my mobile device. Instead of you exceeded 25 downloads, you can replace your 25 downloads once a day. Any new songs you download automatically replace.
Well, that's not bad. That means you really get 50. 25 in the morning, 25 at night. So once you've gone through the first 25,
yes.
you get another 25. That's 50.
Right.
That's 50.
Yeah. And playlists. So,
but
yeah,
this replaces the free subscription.
It does. So, you know, yes, last week we heard that Apple Music is coming out. They're calling it Apple Music.
Oh, I didn't
and
hear that.
That's a rumor from 9 to 5 Mac.
What
Apple,
a name.
Apple Music. Well, it's just like not photos.
Music.
Apparently.
Who?
9 to 5. I still need that. That's
Apple
not gonna be $10 a month.
Apple's been going to labels saying don't let Spotify have any more free airplay. It's bad for you. And remember, of course, Taylor Swift pulled her 1989 album, said you can't have a Spotify because she said, look, I'll leave it on the paid platform, the paid tier, but you can't play it on the free one. Spotify said no. So Taylor Swift says, well, sorry, I'm leaving. I think this is the end of free on Spotify, but $3.99 is a pretty good choice for a lot of us.
Yeah, I mean, I'll try the music when it comes out and see. I hear they have a family plan, which is nice, but you can pay, like, you know,
$15,
yeah,
you get
$15,
all the kids can have it.
Yeah, so right now, RDO, I've been listening to it since it came out, and I like it.
My kids like Spotify, but this might move them over to RDO because the price is probably adequate, even for heavy music listeners.
Right.
All right, this is stop watching. Go home. The show. Do not, whatever you do, watch my app. I'm telling you, consider yourself
okay.
warm.
Well, I got another show to do. So
remember the trouble I had to send out. The addiction. Remember Wii Rule? Couldn't stop playing it. Addictive stuff. I think that people on the staff here should understand that they've got to protect me from this kind of game. From myself.
In all kinds of ways, yes.
But no. Mr. F. and Dunn, he's just on the other side here. F. and Dunn showed me. I should throw things at him. He said, I shouldn't show these to you, but I'm going to anyway. Sim City Build It. Do you know about this? Do you ever play Sim City?
I played The Sims. I never played that.
Yeah, well, Sim City predated The Sims. It was one of the original Sim games in which you build a city. But for the iPad, Sim City might be a little bit too complicated. So this is an iPad-specific, very much like Wii Rule or Simpsons Tapped Out. Beautiful graphics. I think they've done a nice job. Instead of being in charge of Springfield or a little family farm, you're in charge of a city. You build a city out. You've got factories that can create resources. Let me collect some of my resources. And, of course, there's things you have to do. You know, over time, as the city grows, you might want to build a police department or a fire department. My storage is full. I'll show you how these factories work. Let's see. This is a factory. It's got two slots. I can make hammers. I can make measuring tape. I can make shovels. I'm going to make some hammers because I know I'm going to need more hammers. Hammers and other stuff are used to upgrade buildings. Your buildings start as little tiny houses, and eventually, as you can see, they get to be skyscrapers. This is still fairly early on in the game, level 12. Here's the mayor's house, city hall. And, my dock is open, and the ship is coming to port. Let's see. Let's load it up. It wants a couple of tape measures. Let's pack those in. All right. Cargo ship loaded. Cast off cargo ship. I get a little key. I get some money, and the ship goes to sail to other cities. Just like most of these games, you can visit other people's towns. There's Evan Dunn's city. He's got a pathetic little town, just hardly going anywhere. I can sell things or buy things. Maybe, apparently, Evan Dunn decided I'm going to turn Leo onto this game, but and then abandon it. Thanks, Evan Dunn, but at least he gave me a hammer. If I had a hammer, I'd play SimCity, build it all day long. Let's do some upgrading. So, I need two chairs. Fortunately, I have a furniture factory. I can build the chairs. This one needs some plastic. Let's upgrade that building here. These, I don't have the materials to upgrade. Also, occasionally, you'll have opportunities to sell stuff. If I had three leaks, I could sell it for 496 coins. Now, you may say, well, this looks like fun. It's free, isn't it? Absolutely, it's completely free. Let's go and make some stuff. How about some metal in that factory? I'm going to make some more plastic in this factory. It takes time, 8 or 9 minutes. It's one of those games you can come and go and visit, play at your leisure. I leave it sometimes all night, and then my Sims get all unruly. You do have to have fire protection. There's the firehouse. And you see, it protects this part of the city, but if I were to put some new buildings somewhere else, they get burned down, so you got to be very careful about where you place them. There's all sorts of things you can build in parks, education, transportation, eventually even houses of worship, landmarks, gambling. There's gambling, yes. Sewage is very important. You got to make sure you got a working sewage system. And I did. I invested early on in a really nice sewage plant. There it is for my town. This is, I hate to say it, a lot of fun. Now, you may say, well, you don't seem to have to spend any money. And in fact, you really don't. But it's like all of these games, maybe a little slower, maybe a little less exciting. If you want to spend money, you can. $5 will get you 250 sim bucks, 100 bucks, 8,500 simoleons.
Wow. That's a bill.
No. I spent hundreds of dollars on donuts. I did. Hundreds, literally.
Really?
Yes, on the Simpsons stand down. Also $400. They have my money. I'm not giving them any more money.
Just your time.
But time is money, and this says it's quite a time sink. I think I could have written a novel in the amount of time it took to build this city. Should I grow more? I don't know. What are those, leeks and potatoes? I don't know what that is. But the farmer's market, more leeks and potatoes. So my warning to you is don't get involved. Just stay away from this game. It will suck you in. It will drain your life of all meaning. Pretty soon you'll be sitting here. You'll be tapping. Your loved ones will say, Daddy, what's for dinner? I'll be right with you. I've got to plant some more seeds in my virtual economy. On the other hand, what's life for, after all?
Besides playing games on your iPad.
Sims is free. Don't buy anything. Okay, give $10.
That's it.
No more.
I will go buy some leeked potatoes for you with my Apple Watch.
Doesn't take Apple Watch. SimCity. SimCity Build It is the name of this. And by the way, one nice thing, it's available on iPad and iPhone. Does not yet have an Apple Watch version. However, what's nice, if you sign in the Game Center, you can have the same city on all of your iDevices, which is great. Android, too.
Excellent. All right, that's it for this first episode of iOS Today.
I'm sorry, did you say something? I was building.
Yes.
Building
that's
an empire.
Time
How do you like the new show? Let us know.
I like it.
Did we change it? Look at the email. Do we have iOS Today?
Not yet.
So it's iPad Today still.
Yeah.
You know, I can help you with that.
Yeah. I think I might.
I know somebody in the engineering department.
On that, then I can do that. So you can email us, you can call us. Our voicemail is still the same. The number is right here in front of my face for me to tell you. It's 757-504-iPad.
We gotta fix that.
Yeah, and we gotta fix the thing too.
You're still Sarah?
I got a list of things to do. I write out
get to it, Maroni.
Tonight, which is
coming up on most of these same stations.
In an hour.
Techers Tonight every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Pacific, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, 2300 UTC. We are here. You know, I think now that we have this all set up, we we've got the hat rack, we've got all the stands. I think we could probably do this round about 12:30, do you think? Maybe 1 p.m. Pacific time.
Yeah, let's do it. We're
3:30 or 4 p.m. Eastern time.
But you don't have...
2130 to 2200 UTC. That's a lot of that.
Yes. Well, just get it from your favorite podcast. It's free to you.
You know what I know everybody wants? John, what are the names of these stands? Because these are nice. Do you even know? He's going to get the box.
All right.
Does it say so on the bottom or anything? I like these. It's like a boomerang on the bottom.
They're great. I love them too.
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks for joining us. Yeah. We'll see you next time. Now, what, is it a towel one?
Oh, yeah, the...
We should throw our hats in the ring.
Okay.
On iOS Today! Woo!
All right.
What do you think we need to do, Watson, to make this set work for you? Because he says we need to do some work on this set. Is it too colorful? Halter? It's the Halter Portable Rotating iPad Stand.
Okay. I think if Padre just does that a lot, it would be good. All right, so should we do a tease then?
It needs more cowbell.
Okay.
All right. Oh, yeah. Kind of cool. Yeah, we gotta get our heads out of the shot. Oh. And my earpiece should be on the other side too, because I turned my head.
And I didn't realize I was the camera for a while.
And besides that, it was perfect. Now, how do we do this? Do we do it a cold open or no?
Yeah, let's do. Don't we need to do a cold open?
Do we do a title?
Like. Oop.
Like this is iOS Today, episode 48, recorded Monday, May 18th, 2015. Can we do a name?
A name or
like
a
show? Well, what is the topic?
Activity app.
What? Let's call it activity app.
Kick your tail feather.
Kick your tail feather. It's too dark. Set's too dark. The gear too dark. Well, we don't want flat white. We want shadowing. Our gas.
Cool. Everyone was impressed, and that's really why you should have things to impress other people.
secret Apple Watch secrets with Jason Snell.
Apple Watch secrets with Jason Snell.
Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. My fingers is starting to hurt. But we have got a lot of leaves. And I know this is not very interesting to look at me cutting leaves all night, but It's not intended that anyone should look at this for 3 hours or 4 hours. Oopsie. Just look in once a while and see how it goes. And then I'm will be a happy guy. This fall we will go and change it a little, but I have not planned it all out yet, but as further I get with this, the more interesting it will be. When we start to make all the people and the animals and the make them so we can animate them, and we get our landscape built, then it will be a little funnier to, more fun to look at. This repetition of doing the same thing over and over and over again, it will stop. All these trees will always be the worst part. Printing trees a very long time and making them, but we are getting to the end of it, and before you know it we have a whole forest where we can play in. Playground for Flint and his friend. All the other people in the movie. as I said from the start, when I first started this, that it will be a trial and error when you haven't made a movie before, then you have to learn along the way. Both small and big things. And I have wasted a lot of time on things that I know now how to do, and there will be more setbacks because it's impossible to think it all through every little detail from start to finish. You cannot do that, even that I try all the time to think think it all through the end, every little detail, but no. That's not that easy. Remember to enjoy the journey too, because else you run dead in it, you get tired of it, so it would be easier if you had some colleagues to do it together with, so when one is down, the others can keep up the spirit. But as I see now, the clock is midnight, so I will say thank you, and we got all of them clipped. So hopefully I'll see you again tomorrow, and we will start to mount a lot of trees to leaves to the trees. So good night, and thanks for the visits.